Years ago, I was having so many cancer patients come into my office. It was like I was an oncologist. I said, how are all these cancer patients finding me? Because I wasn't equipped to treat advanced cancers. And so the Lord had me go to a fellowship, an advanced nutritional fellowship for integrative medicine on how to treat cancer. So I studied under a lot of MD Anderson doctors and speakers and people from cancer institutes down in Mexico. And he kind of showed me a plan. But one day we had a speaker that came in, and he said, and I asked him, what is the key thing you found over all of these nutritional cancer therapies that is the most important thing for cancer? And this was years ago. And he said, by far, it's the ketogenic diet, but no one can follow that. Well, that stuck with me, and I prayed about it, and then I started putting the pieces of the ketogenic diet for cancer together. And I had to figure out a way that we could do the diet that would be easy for my patients to do. So I started I wrote out a menu for my patients to follow. With a ketogenic diet, we literally flip a switch from burning sugar as your primary fuel to burning fat as your primary fuel. When your body shifts from burning sugar, see, cancers love sugars. They're sugar feeders. That's why when we do PET scans, they use fluoroxydeoxyglucose, which is a radioactive tracer linked to glucose, so they can locate the cancers. And then they measure the activity.
It's sugar. You need to break it down. It's sugar.
Exactly. It's a sugar molecule attached to a radioactive tracer. Cancers gobble it up. So the cancers appear as bright splotches on the PET scan. And so what happens
is... It's like Pac-Man. Have you seen that game, Pac-Man? So when they put that glucose sugar in there, Pac-Man comes and eats it, yum, 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 and lights up because it's attracted to
it. Right. So they measure where it is by the SUV value, or the standardized uptake value of the FDG glucose radioactive tracer sugar that's taken up by the cancer, so they can locate where the cancers are. So what we do with the ketogenic diet is we shift their metabolism from burning sugar to burning fat. When we shift their metabolism, cancers have a very, very difficult time using fat as their fuel source. They are primarily glycolytic. They use sugar and glycogen as their main fuel. So when you shift to burning fat as your main energy source, all of a sudden the cancer goes into survival mode.